Hi guys, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
If you have been an Android developer, you will start worrying about some of these aspects. Like, is my coding style correct? Is my code following some standard architecture? Should I follow MVC, MVP, or MVVM? Which architecture is the recommended architecture for Android application development? Where to fit Android components in generic architecture like service, broadcast receiver, content provider? They have their own life cycle, which are pretty much decided by the Android framework. So how do they fit in MVC or MVP or MVVM? And other than that, how to unit test your Android applications? Well, these are very much legitimate questions. But to be able to answer these questions, you have to understand where you are in the overall learning curve of Android. What do I mean by that is, you cannot start learning Android directly from Jetpack. That will only make you feel a little bit more nervous about Android application development. However, the better option would be, you can get started with the very basics like activity, service, broadcast receiver, content provider, move up the ladder till data persistence, and you can still learn many things like location, push notifications. And after learning that, you will reach a plateau where you will start worrying about few of the questions that a very good programmer will start worrying about. How should I organize my code? How to make the application more secure? How to achieve a better separation of concern? Am I following the proper solid principles or not? Whether whatever the code that I have written, is it for long time usage? And have I written my modules in a reusable manner? When you start worrying about these questions, this is the time that you will have to start talking about MVC, MVP, and MVVM. And once you understand what these different architectures are trying to achieve and what are the limitations, pros, and cons, then probably you are in a position to really appreciate what Android Jetpack does. So trying to learn Android application development directly from Jetpack is not at all recommended. So this tutorial series is for those people who are somewhere here and want to achieve there. Now, before we get started, we have to ask some very pertinent questions. Questions such as, does Android inherently support view and controller separation? Is activity really a view, or is activity a controller? Or is it both? If you are wondering, this is pretty silly question. I had asked exactly this question on the community page of my channel. And if you see the responses, it is very diverse. As you can see, most of the people feel that activity is both view and controller. So if it is both view and controller, how do we separate them? And ultimately, what is the current state of affairs? If we understand what we do currently as a newbie Android developer, then I think we would be in a much better position to understand how we need to move towards a MVC or MVP or other architectures. So if you think in terms of what is a model, it is nothing but a data. It could be your bean classes or databases or content provider or even your backend from where you are fetching your data. And view is nothing but the UI. It concerns mainly itself with how to display the data. It doesn't really care where it is getting the data from. As long as it gets the data, it should only worry about how should I display it. And then comes the controller. Controller is typically the piece which is doing event handling, navigation of different streams, communication between the model and view. So let's have a look at a sample Android application and try to understand how code looks currently.
You are
pretty familiar with this particular application where we are maintaining a to-do list. You have a to-do item and a place where you want to do a particular task. And when you want to enter a new to-do item, all you have to do is new task and new place, click on add, and then if you want to delete something, you want to enter the ID and click on remove, and in the same way the modify will work. So if you try to understand how our code is organized, you basically have the bean class to do, and then you have a database. This is the database adapter. It has got the SQLite open helper class. So to some extent, these two packages and classes represent model, and then you have activity, and in the activity you initialize various views and you have a layout file. This layout file gets initialized in the main activity. So this is where the view part comes into picture. And then if you come down, the event handling is also present in the main activity. So what should happen on the click of the button, like add, remove and modify. I am invoking some methods here. Inside that I am doing the logic of actually modify the model, and after that I am invoking set new list, which once again updates the UI. So what we have understood from the glimpse at the code is you basically have a activity and you have database access object or a database service or a SQLite open helper class or an adapter, anything for that matter, which represents model. And then activity basically fetches the data from the model. Any UI update that needs to happen whenever model changes, activity will do that. Other than that, whenever user clicks on add button, delete or modify button, so those are the event handling, and based on that model needs to be updated. So in a way, activity is view and also a controller. If we try to represent in a slightly different way, what you typically have is a view controller role that activity is playing and the view itself. Whenever the view is updated, the view controller is notified, and if the view controller needs to update the view, that also is done from the view controller to the view. And sometimes you may actually want to do a network operation. In that case, the view controller will do that thing for you, and once data is available, it is once again handed back to the view controller, and the view controller will once again update the view. This is how a very classic Android application would get written. Some may even try to do a little bit modified version than this, in which you basically have different views and data and they just communicate with one another in a very random manner. So at max, I can call it as view model architecture. There is not even a controller here. The view itself is doing pretty much everything. The problem with both of these two mechanisms is you have no clear separation of concern. The controller is doing the updation of the view. The view is doing updation of the data. Lot of things are trying to do too many things. Then difficult to unit test. If you want to unit test any component, those components should be independent of one another. Right now they are not. And then there is a very bad coupling. There are too many dependencies between different components here, and then loose cohesion. View is trying to do a bit of work for the controller. The controller is trying to do a bit of work for the view, and both of them have a dependency of model in a very bad way. So basically this architecture is pretty much a disaster waiting to happen in the long run, because in the long run, if we continue to write our application in this way, it will become very difficult to maintain our source code. So at best, what we can call this way of writing our application is bad Android architecture. So having understood what a bad Android architecture looks like, I think now probably you are in a much better position to appreciate why we need to separate model, view and controller. And with the way how things currently stand in Android, activity is both view and controller. Model to some extent is separated, but view and controller are both together stuck in an activity. So how do we separate them? So in the next video, we will continue to explore this and try to come up with a better understanding of how to separate view and controller from the activity to achieve better separation of concern. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.